away from Pastrnak. David Pastrnak has been the hottest stick for the Boston Bruins. To Schaller, to Pastrnak, hands it out for Krejci, back in front, stopped by Price as the puck gets tipped over the net. Corey Crew with a great chance for Boston.
Radulov, with a tight turn, sends Pacioretty up the wing, Carlos stumbles and goes down. Pacioretty closes the backhand after pulling Rask toward the middle, but Rask dragged the right leg. And Bergeron clears back into the skates of Krejci, keeps his balance to get the puck up to the line. Lekkonen making the Bruins battle for every inch. Byron swoops on the forehand, goes right to the goal with it, and Rask keeps it out of there despite the jamming efforts of the Canadiens. A little mistake in the defensive zone can turn into an emergency in a hurry.
Yeah, just a little too soft on the puck. Schaller's trying to one-hand that puck back to Krug. You got to be a little bit stronger on the puck. And pretty good, strong net move. Byron's going to protect the puck, try to go short side, and Plekanec. Two or three whacks at it. Krug's trying to hold his balance. Rask trying to keep that left pad, left skate pinned to the ice and pinned to the post.
Goes up high to Torrey Krug with a shot that missed. Pastrnak right back after it. Pass through his legs. Pressure on to Krejci. Stopped by Price. And he'll reach out for the puck to cover it up.
Price is so relaxed back there. And all kinds of chaos, commotion going on, but he just always remains in his position, always keeps his composure. And Krejci with the opportunity. There's big David Backes in front. Bergeron with the nice pass. And again, Krejci with that quick shot. Look at Price. There's the calmness. Down in the butterfly, still makes himself big. Cuts down the angle. It doesn't really give Krejci a lot to shoot at. And controls the rebound for good men.
The corner gives to Yemelin. Dano tries to shove it in front. Lekkonen to Shaw. Oh, what a save by Tuukka Rask. Rask coming right to left across the crease. A sweet feed, and Shaw elevated the puck, but Rask makes a splendid save.
It's like the Bruins almost forgot about Shaw, because when he went up the right wing, you see on the right side of your screen, he gets laid out by Backes, and then he just kind of drifts into space. And after McQuaid makes a big hit on Dano in the corner, that puck comes to the front of the net. Nice little backhand feed. Again, Lekkonen making a nice play. Shaw, as you pointed out, Jack, he's able to raise that puck. Rask had to get across, and he had to play big.
In the middle part of the second period, Krejci dangling over the line, 3-on-3. Saucer pass. Pastrnak rings the bell on the stick side of Price. Great chances at both ends, and here's a 2-on-1 for Montreal. Gallagher to Plekanec. Radulov playing catch with Pacioretty, has Markov going down the slot, in and out of Rask's glove. Shaw jams. Pacioretty there too, but Rask holds the line, and the Bruins can get Brandon Carlo a new stick.
Yeah, that's a huge faceoff to get. Rask doesn't get it initially in terms of a clean catch with the glove hand, and it came free. Exchange between Marchand and Carlo. So you got your right shooting defenseman playing with a left-handed stick. You got a guy that's trying to front Weber without a stick. And the Canadians try to keep it on this side, the left-handed side of the ice, meaning the left shooters. Shaw gets a second chance opportunity, but then a huge face-off, a whistle for the Bruins penalty killing.
Marchand trying to get it back for Backes. Mitchell got it away, and now it's Brad Marchand that's on it. Trying to center in front. Bergeron with a shot. Great stop by Price. Bergeron's right back on it.
And the Bruins have numbers up ice. Hayes on the right. Zarnik on the left. McQuaid busting down the middle. Zarnik scores! Austin Zarnik beats Carey Price short side. And the Bruins lead 1-0.
And there might have been even a penalty on Montreal coming on this play. McQuaid finds that loose puck in his feet back in the defensive zone. He turns the puck up quick. The Canadians get caught deep. And now the Bruins got a little something going in terms of numbers. You see four Canadians below the dot. McQuaid on the net drive. Jimmy Hayes also on that drive. McQuaid got knocked down. And I can't believe there was going to be a penalty on that play to the Canadians. But it's a moot point. Austin Zarnik getting an opportunity to play center tonight. We touched on the tweaking of the forward lines. Zarnik had a great camp because he was playing center, was confident there, has the opportunity tonight. And a beautiful shot to beat Price on the blocker side, short side, to give the Bruins a late second period goal to take the lead.
Puck, Brandon Carlo flattens it, gets it to center. Tim Schaller can't get it through Gallagher. Gallagher holds up, closes the shot, saved by Rask, and he dives on it as Gallagher continues to joust. Brendan Gallagher bringing the full energy and being a pest to the Bruins all night, but it's still 1-0.
And the Canadians trying to find the equalizer. Torrey Mitchell in, can't get a shot, Byron scores! And there's the equalizer. Paul Byron makes it a 1-1 game.
And Paul Byron, if there's one team he loves playing against, it's the Boston Bruins. Already has two game-winning goals on the season. Mitchell with the break gets his stick lifted. Rask had committed to Torrey Mitchell. That's why the whole other side of the net was open. And there's Paul Byron. Goes right to the front of the net, stops, and backhands that into the empty net, past a sprawling Tuukka Rask. Byron continues to be a thorn in the Boston Bruins side.
He's exhausted right now. Try him.
Spooner tosses the backhand to Krug. Back to Spooner in front. He dinks. He scores. Spooner sticks a fork in him, and the Bruins win in sudden death, beating Montreal at Bell Center 2-1.
Hockey justice for the Bruins tonight, Jack. They had this game won, a late goal regulation. They had it won in overtime, had the goal taken away. And I love the fact that the Bruins recognized that Radulov was beatable in this situation, and they attacked him. And it's huge that a guy like Ryan Spooner gets the game winner. I mean, this is a great play here. Protect the puck, throw it to space. That's exactly where Krug is. You see two Canadians drift over. Now it's one-on-one. Spooner against Radulov. He just beat him back to the net. Great pass, great execution, and a nice finish. And it looks like Montreal's hanging around. Was there an offside on the long pass up to Marchand? Is that where the initial entry was? Because I believe it was. And they'd be taking a look and see if that pass was offside.
The Bruins are going down the tunnel. The goal is under review. Only one member of the Bruins is still on the ice. And that is Zdeno Chara.
Yeah, the Bruins went for that long pass up the ice deck as the Canadians were changing out after Radulov had fell down around the offensive blue line. So it was a quick up by Zarnik, left side of your screen.
He's offside.
Oh, you can't tell from that angle just yet.
I think I can. I think both skates are past the blue line.
It is close. It is close. It has to be conclusive, irrefutable, in order to bring this game back out. And it may happen.
The linesman was not on the line, not in position to make the call.
You better be 100% sure that that's offside with proof.
After video review initiated by Toronto, the goal stands. The play is inconclusive. It's onside. Good goal.
Well, the Bruins get the first break of the year on video review.